Guys, it's Adrian here, and in this tutorial I will show you how to create a complex cylindrical shape. By the end of this tutorial you will learn how to create any complex cylindrical shape with ease. Now there are three different methods to create this kind of effect here on your source cylinder. The method number one is that we only want to create one segment of this object, like this one as well, like this. We model this one and we duplicate it all around to get one single object, to get a beautiful cylindrical shape. The method number two is that we start by creating a cylinder again, and we again create only one segment, like this segment, and we're gonna use a symmetry modifier to duplicate the rest. And method number three is that we again create one single segment, we duplicate it on a planar surface, then we use a bend modifier. So the method number one, we have to create one segment and duplicate it all around. But in here, first we have to do a little bit of math here and figure out how many polygons do we need in the first place. All right, so let me go and show you. We want to model this object, right? So this object right here, it has repetitive details. It has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and about 12 repetitive details. So we only need model one, right? We duplicate the rest. So for one single segment, we need about 6 polygons. Let me show you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to create this curvature right here. All right, this curvature. So I'm gonna do exactly that. I'm gonna want to create a cylinder and model only 6 sides. So before we do that, we have to do a little bit of math here, right? So we need 6 polygons. And this whole object has 12 sides, right? So 6 times 12 will give us 42 sides, 42 polygons. So we need a cylinder start by 42 polygons. So I'm going to do exactly that. I'm going to create a cylinder like that. All right, I'm going to convert it to edible poly, remove the bottom we don't need. I'm going to go to the top view. I'm gonna select or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm gonna Control I, invert it, and delete the rest. Be sure to don't change the pivot. So in here, I'm gonna tweak the vertices to get our desired shape that we want. Okay, something like this. After we satisfy with the shape that we create, we want to duplicate it all around to create a perfect cylindrical shape. So but we don't know how many what angle do we need to rotate it around to get a perfect cylindrical shape, because if we do not, you know, if we're not careful, we cannot get a perfect cylindrical shape here all around. So we know that we have a 72 side, right? 72 side all around. So how many angle does a perfect cylindrical shape have? It has 360, right? So 360 it takes to perfect to create a perfect cylindrical shape. 360 divided by 72 sides that we have, it gives us 5. It takes 5 degrees for each one of these segments to create a whole cylinder, right? So I'm gonna, we have 6 sides right here, so I'm gonna times it by 6, so it gives us 30 degrees for one segment to create whole cylinder. I'm gonna rotate it around by 30 degree angle. So let me look, rotate it around on the Z axis. Before that, I'm gonna activate angle snap. I'm gonna change the angle snap to 30 degree angle. I'm gonna rotate it around to create our beautiful perfect cylindrical shape. I'm gonna number of copy instance, use 11 copies to create 12 side as well. And if I go back here, if I change, for example, this one as well, I can move it down like that because it's instance, and boom, we create our beautiful cylindrical shape. We get a little bit of math here. It may sound complex, but it's very easy. Try it out and do some practice and you will get a good sense of what this all about. So the method number two, let's jump to the method number two. And for the methods, Method number two, we just want to create a cylindrical shape as well. I'm going to start by cylinder 72 sides. Let me do the same thing here. Remove the bottom, remove the top, and let's go to top view. And in here, again, I want to select 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. Now we have the 6 sides. I want to let's just start by select this one. This is better at the center. Let's move it up a bit. Change the topology to get the desired shape. All right. Now after I satisfy with the result here, I'm gonna go to the symmetry, go to the planner, and I'm gonna activate the symmetry on y-axis. Then I'm gonna rotate it around by the half of the degrees that we have here. So 30 divided by 2, it gives us 15. So 15 degree angle. Let me go to the angle snap and change the angle to 15. All right. So I'm gonna go to the symmetry mirror and 50 and rotate it around. And I'm gonna do the same thing here. I'm gonna copy and paste the symmetry modifier over and over again to get our perfect cylindrical shape here. The advantage that symmetry modifier have here is that we don't need to calculate how many angle and how many side do we have. We have to kind of guessing, you know, guessing game, just how many, you know, how is that, how much we can do an angle snap, you know, rotate it around to figure out the angle and rotate it around to get a perfect cylindrical shape. It's very easy. But another change that we have in Autodesk 2022 is that we get a radial symmetry as well. So let me show you that it's a very fast method of all of them. This is the best method of all. If I go to this radial, okay, I want to, for example, 12 count, right? I go to 12 count. Let me go to the mirror and let me rotate it all around. As I rotate it, I get our perfect cylinder. Just like that, in it less than a 1 minute, 2 seconds, in a matter of seconds, I have this beautiful cylindrical shape. How awesome is that? It's a perfect method. Create a modifier, symmetry modifier, and go to the radial on the z-axis and rotate it around to get your beautiful cylindrical shape. Awesome. Now the method number three is that we want to create only one segment of this object. Again, I'm gonna go to the top view. I'm gonna create a planner. I'm gonna create a planner shape or plan. Let's create a plane right here. Okay, we know that we need 6 side, right? We need 6 side in here. I don't need that. All right, so we have 6 polygon. So let me again tweak the vertices to get our desired shape in here. What I can do is just select one of these and go to the FFT modifier and just move this one up to create this kind of curve right here. Easy. Okay, let me move it up a bit. All right, I'm gonna go to my effect pivot only. I'm gonna move this pivot to this vertex at the start of our object right here. I'm gonna move it, snap it to the right by 11 times. All right, let me maximize it a bit. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right. I'm gonna, we have 12 objects selected right here. I'm gonna quick attach it. All right. Now after I attach it, I isolate it. Then I'm gonna add a bend modifier to our object right here. At the bend modifier angle, we want to rotate it around by 360. All right, so angle is 360, direction 90. and switch it to the x-axis, and boom, we have our beautiful cylindrical shape. And this was the end of this tutorial. Be sure to subscribe, hit the thumbs up button, and see you guys next time. Take care. Bye-bye.